Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here, your host on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. So in today's video, what we're going to be doing is taking a look at the ever-growing popularity-wise Coda. And Coda was an application that got released in late 2017. And essentially it's a docs application that allows you to create interactive documents with the formats of Excel and things like that. I'll explain it more detail. And just make sure before we dive in, if you want to skip ahead to certain elements of Coda or you are a bit time poor, then feel free to use the timestamps below. You can even skip this introduction and all of the maybe more boring stuff as we get started. So you do use the timestamps below if you want to skip ahead. So this company was actually created by a Googler called Alex Dunui. I probably got the pronunciation wrong. It's a fellow former Googler who created this with his team. And their goal was really to try and create a new kind of productivity app, combining almost like software or apps with your document experience. Now, this isn't something that we have brand new experience on. Quip, I think it is, Q-U-I-P, by Salesforce, have been developing this over the last couple of maybe year or two now. And applications like Notion are taking another leap in this. Obviously, Google Docs and Dropbox Paper have been present for a fair while now, maybe 2-3 years. Obviously, Google Docs much longer. And the likes of Airtable and Monday are making an impression. But this is really more docs focused. And what I want to do today is give you my full opinion and first impressions of the application. So you can see here, this is a sort of landing page that I got when I created my Coda account. You can create a new document and that's baseline from their like structure, or you can import from Excel or Google Sheets, from Trello or from a CSV file. But in this case, I'm just going to create a brand new document. And it's really simple. As you get started with, it will obviously create you a new document, and you pretty much get landed on a page that sort of looks like workflowy to some extent. A workflowy, another sort of document focused application. But what I'm going to start doing is I'm going to create my first Coda document. Remember, you can skip forward all of this if you don't find it useful. So here we go. On the left hand side, you obviously have something called the outline, which is for your sections and folders. You can and create a new folder as well. So for example, if I was like, top secret documents, and I'm gonna create a section below it, maybe, just below that, you can see here. So FBI files, I'm probably gonna get flagged up for this. As you can see here, once you create a new section, you can start modifying document per section. So for example, if I started typing in, let me just rename this one to introduction. Hello everyone. And then I went down to FBI files. Obviously it would be almost a separate document, very similar to the way that OneNote separates stuff. So here we are with the, obviously the introduction. You get full text formatting, obviously a large header. The font looks quite nice and you obviously get all of the bolding. You can add monospacing, highlights as well. So for example, if I wanted to just highlight a bit of text, I can easily do that. You get bullet points. And these are all accessible in the keyboard shortcuts. And you can insert hyperlinks, insert emoji, and even add or hide comments, all of that. And you can get the information to the sections, and you can also get an outline of the tables you've created inside of this. So you're probably wondering, you know, what more can I add? Of course, there is this magical plus button here where a great deal of information comes from. And this is where it brings together the likes of sort of like Notion and Monday.com and other applications like that. So if I go to a new table, I can create a new table in here and it's interactive straight away. Now I can even open this one up and actually see stuff inside it, but it's really simple table layout. You can obviously retitle the table, so you can put like proof of aliens. This is a really bad example. It's probably going to be flagging me up for this. And of course, obviously you've got each of the columns, but you can modify what actually goes in the columns like you would inside an Excel document, pretty much the extent. You can even filter it and add all of the different layouts. So you can add even card layouts if you wanted to. So if you wanted to go off for like a traditional, I believe it's the Eisenhower method or the matrix even, you can do. You can even go off a Gantt chart from here too. So if you wanted to create a Gantt chart based on it with start, end date, and start, end date, and duration, which is pretty impressive. So it's pretty flexible. So that was adding tables and Gantt charts. Of course, you can import it from the likes of what I mentioned before, Excel, Trello, and that one. You can add images very similar to the fashion that you would in a Google Doc or a Dropbox paper. You can link people or even rows. You can create formulas, and you can even use control functions like sliders, information like that. Oop, there we go, cool sliders, a date range picker, a single select, a multi-select, and all that sort of loveliness. And what's cool is, I guess to some extent, you could create your own team form document, but then not have the results at the end. So it's really manipulative to however you like to set things up. And of course, you can use the search functionality. So if I just put, hello, it's me, and searched me, as you can see, you can work out where it actually comes from and skip to that different section. So it's quite an interactive experience to some extent. I think they might have confused some users in terms of this setup, like being able to add a Gantt chart and the cards. But in this case, what I want to do is show you their demonstration function, which puts it more into sort of practice. And as we go into this one, you'll be able to see a bit more detail behind it. So you can see here that they've added emoji, they've added the beautiful lists, abilities. And of course, they've got sort of like a nice overview of the sort of structure of it, and it's very easy to do, so I thought it would be more detailed than that, if I'm honest. So I'm going to go over to gallery. So gallery is an area that allows you to create your own setup. So very similar to Notion templates, you have, and even monday.com templates, you have the ability to use their templates function to skip ahead. So you can create anything from Kanban projects all the way to project launch information, a simple to-do list, an interview day based on a database, and anything. There's really like loads of structures, and there's even people who have submitted their own, which is quite cool. So you can use all of these. And I'm just gonna grab like a full example one, one that looks quite intricate. I'm gonna use the project launched hub, and I'm going to copy the document. So you can see the maker, it was Joe Demento for this one. He is one of the team over at Coda. So you can see here a copy of it goes into my file, and of course I can manipulate anything in this, but you can start to see how intricate it is. Obviously I've got a good link to it, everything like that. It's sort of like a onboarding document, but let's say I want to go to the master tracker and go to teams and tasks. You can see everything here. He's even added all of the details and what's actually been started and what hasn't. So you have the ability, once you create that table setup, to actually manipulate the sections here and actually have specific statuses. You can even add indications of dates and even how much effort you gave per day, which is quite cool. And you can assign people to the different areas too. So you can actually change who this one's assigned to me. You can change who you've given it to, very similar to monday.com. So in terms of that gallery section, the template section, you can use it however you like. There is a range of categories: personal design, event planning, HR, project management, and a host of other ones. There's a simple productivity section, which will allow you to do things like GTD, even Eisenhower matrix, and a lot of other things. So it's very open and intricate, and of course you can search it and submit your own. Now they do have Coda 1.0 at 101, schema design, formulas, how to do all of these, and they will give you as much help as they can. They've got a help section and also Coda Academy, which is this section here. Sorry, I overcomplicated that one. So in terms of being able to learn how to do all this, it seems like a pretty promising tool. Now, what I would say is that Coda is very early days. I'm not sure I like that full outline bar on the left-hand side, but apart from that, it's actually pretty manipulative in terms of being able to create your own setup and get started. And of course, inviting team members makes it easier as you go across your day. So there's lots of these. In terms of Coda, challengingmonday.com, this is actually probably one of the closest competitors. Anyway guys, hopefully that gave you a nice overview of Coda Docs. Let me know in the comments what you think about it. Again, if you pop a comment in the comments, I'll pick one of you out for a invite access to this one. And of course, once you get access, you'll get access to some code and everything there. Anyway, guys, thank you very much for stopping by. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.